I'm talking about some tips that you can do to handle when you work with different time zones between coworkers. I'm using the new Outlook for Mac interface to show you these, but many of these tips are transferable to other platforms, such as Gmail and Google Calendar. The first place I'm going to start is by heading over to the calendar. If I'm on the East Coast and I work with a company on the West Coast in the United States, I'd like to add that time zone to the calendar because it's just easier to see what time of day my colleagues are going to be in meetings when I am. I can add an additional time zone here on the left-hand side next to mine. To do that, on the top of the screen, click Outlook and choose Preferences. From here, click Calendar. And at the bottom of the screen, I can click Show Second Time Zone in Day and Week View. I'll select the time zone I want to see, in this case, Pacific Time for the US and Canada. And now I can close out. Here it is on the left-hand side. Now, Outlook for Windows and the Google platform also has this functionality. It's just easier to see it at a glance. In fact, down here at the bottom of the screen is the horizontal line telling me what the current time of day is. I can even glance right over and see what time it is for them. Let's create a new meeting. I'll click New Event. Something else that's very important when you're creating meetings between people who work in multiple time zones all over the globe is to include the time zone information with that meeting. So I'll click the globe icon. This is going to add a time zone field to the event. So now when I'm creating this meeting, the computer and Outlook knows that this event is being created in 4:30 p.m. Eastern Time. So when I send the invitations out, every single computer, no matter where you are, it's going to be added to the right time. I'll click discard. But the nice thing is, I can turn that feature on once, and every other time I create meetings, that time zone field will be there. Let's now head into email. If I'm creating a new message, I need to be careful of the time of day when I'm sending it to my coworkers. For example, if I'm on the East Coast and I'm sending an email at 8 o'clock in the morning to somebody in the West Coast, I don't want to send it that early because I'm afraid their phone is going to chirp or they'll get some sort of notification at 5 o'clock in the morning, their time. So what I like to do once I address my email is to click the down arrow next to send. From here, I can choose to send this message later. For example, if it's 6 o'clock my time in the morning, I'll send it at 11 o'clock a.m. their time. This way, it's 8 o'clock in the morning on the Pacific Coast, and I know that's a reasonable time to send an email to a coworker. I'll click cancel on this. This is what I usually do when I'm sitting down to send my emails in the morning. I always do the send later option when I'm sending emails to people on the West Coast.